AquaChef is a sous vide smart cooker, which was introduced last year. And we're very proud to say that during last year, the product was really taken hold and is now in the kitchens of at-home cooks, culinary schools like this, and professional chefs around the country. And it's a real honor for us to be here today. It was a few months ago that Chef Mullins contacted us, inquired if he could obtain a few of the units to utilize here, and boy, we were thrilled. You know, for somebody like us to get contacted by Lake Fort Honor Blue about utilizing some product was exciting, and we quickly mobilized and got some units up here, and then we were even more thrilled after discussion with Chef Sahoni to ask him to come here and do a demonstration and show off the product as we're doing today. And so we're grateful to the staff here at Lake Fort Honor Blue. And I'm happy to say that today we're here with the AquaChef Test Kitchen Director, Chef Melissa Torcedo, Chef Mel. And a little background on her, she had a youthful love affair with all things Julia Child. And she catapulted that passion into the art of cooking and a successful career in the culinary arts. And I should note that she is a graduate of Lake Fort Honor Blue, Pasadena campus in 2005, so she certainly knows what you are. And with that, I am going to turn it over to Chef Mel to talk about AquaChef and sous vide.
Thank you so much for having me, and really am happy to be here, especially at my alma mater. So, you know, I'm excited. So, how many of you have got to actually work with AquaChef? Well, you guys get to play with it, and some of you get to take one home today. And how many of you have heard of sous vide? That's good. Okay, that's good. So what does sous vide mean? Sous vide means under vacuum. And when I say under vacuum, that means we're going to put our food into a vacuum environment. We're going to place it into a bag. We're going to vacuum out the air. We're going to cook the food in a water bath. And what's great about cooking in a water bath, I like to refer to it like a warm, perfect sweater that's always the perfect temperature. So you guys live in Seattle, and sometimes it's warmer and colder outside. If you want it to be done at a right temperature, you're going to put on your perfect sweater. The water bath is going to make sure that your food is never going to overcook. That's what the benefit of sous vide is. So if you're cooking something to, say, 135, the water is never going to get above that. So when you're cooking the sous vide method, you're not cooking at a temperature that is higher or lower. You're cooking at the temperature that the food is going to be finished at. And that's what's really great, because instead of being worried about time, it's more about the temperature. And that's what's really important. And when you're cooking something in a traditional method, exactly like your classroom, in the oven, in the grill, in a broiler, you're always cooking a lot higher, right? Yeah, you guys are always cooking a lot higher. So you set your oven to 400. And you're trying to hope that your food finishes at this certain magic bubble, so it's not overcooked or undercooked. So when you're cooking and you just miss that bubble, your food's overcooked, your food's undercooked. So if you're cooking a chicken, you want it to finish at 165. So you get rid of all the bad bacteria, it's that moist and tender part. And then when you're cooking at 165, you put it in the oven at 400. If you go over, you have dry, nasty chicken. You go under, you have pink in your chicken, and nobody really wants to eat pink in their chicken. You're not going to have a good few days after that. So temperature is more important when you're cooking with sous vide than time. You can cook something for a really long period of time, and it's going to get more succulent and tender. And if you cook it for a shorter amount of time, it'll just be a little bit less tender. And that's what's really great about cooking the sous vide method. So I have some eggs that I'm going to show you that have cooked at different temperatures, and you can see how important that the temperature variance is. Some are 5 degrees and one is 15 degrees higher, and I'll show you that this little degree of difference, you can see that how different it is. So this egg is cooked at 140. And you can see the yolk. It's runny. It's a little runny. The egg white is not completely set. And then I have this egg that was cooked at 5 degrees higher, so at 145. And the egg yolk is more custard-like. You can spread it on a piece of toast and really enjoy that. And then I have this egg that's cooked white is completely set, and the egg yolk solid is almost chalk-like. So this is why we can see temperature is really important, but time was not. All these eggs were cooked for 4 hours. So if I come back 5 hours from now, this egg will look the same, this egg will look the same, and this egg will look the same. Time does not matter when we're cooking the sous vide method. It's temperature is what's important. Okay? So I'm going to also demonstrate a steak, and you guys get to taste the steak, and I hope you like it. So we're going to do a dry rub on the steak, and I have some ribeyes here. Okay. And so I have a dry rub, and you guys get to take home the recipe, and you can use it on, I like it more on beef, but you can use it on pork. Okay, so I just have the ribeye, and take like a small handful. So if you look at this, how many teaspoons or tablespoons are this beef? Have you guys learned that yet? About a tablespoon, right? That was one of my first things I learned in culinary school.
It just looks.
Yeah, so I always did the that. Are you guys carrying fish weights in your pockets yet?
No.
No? Do you know what that is? When you carry fish weights in your pockets? So you can measure out how much stuff weighs just by feeling it. That's what I always did. I just carry fish weights in my pocket so I can always tell. Like, this is a pound, this is a pound and a half. You guys look at that. Okay, and then I'm gonna put this in my sealing environment so I can suck out the air. And this massive steak is a little bit big for my back. And that's okay. We'll just make do. Because what do chefs do? They always make do with what they got, right? To vacuum up the air, just like, okay. And if you were marinating something like in a dry rub, would a steak taste better if it were marinated for an hour or 12 hours?
A dry rub?
Yeah, a dry rub. 12 hours, right? Because it would just be a little bit more intense. But that 1 hour steak wouldn't be horrible, it would still taste pretty good, right? So in imaginary 12 hour land, this was marinated and I placed it in my Aqua Chef at 135. The reason why I'm cooking at 135 is because I like a medium steak. What's great about this is that I'm gonna have a medium steak from edge to edge, instead of if I cooked it in the traditional method, I'm only gonna have a medium steak in the middle, and then I'm gonna have more meat that I really don't wanna eat. So for demonstration purposes, I have a steak here that is already cooked. This is our magic of TV moment. Okay. And my Vanna is going to take over and cut this up for you guys to taste. So I have some questions for you guys. Hopefully you guys will answer. Expecting a lot from you.
Oh yeah, right. High achiever, wannabe.
So how is cooking in the Aqua Chef different than a traditional method?